How long have we been on the road today so far?
Jesus Christ, man, it's 11 o'clock. Oh my God, we're only in Pennsylvania. Should have been in Florida by now.
I love brand new.
All right.
Your band sucks.
They didn't have it down there either.
This is the two weirdest gas stations I've ever been to.
No,
ever.
Weird.
Not in a bad way. I'm just saying.
Shut out what they say. Cause your friends are fucked up anyway. And when they come around, somehow they feel up and you feel down.
What?
The only thing doesn't lift up and lock in.
Well, it's no big deal. I'm just gonna back it in and then we're just gonna take it back off. It'll still move.
We're stuck in Tennessee right now with this problem. We have this problem we put shocks on to help keep this little trailer here up. And apparently the whole shock system that is on, you're not even supposed to put on a van that we have. So we're just trying to find new ones, which apparently Tennessee doesn't even know what shocks are. So we'll be here for a little while and I'll let you know how fucking crazy I am later.
It's the first day of tour.
No, we're not even on the tour yet. We drove for 5 hours.
Drove for 12 hours, and we have another 16 hours before the tour starts. And I'm still wearing pajama pants and flip-flops.
We'll be right back.
let's have another drink and drive yourself home. I hope there's ice on all the roads and you can think of me when you forget your seatbelt, and again when your head goes through the windshield.
Is that what you call tact? You're as subtle as a brick and the small on my back. So let's end this call and end this conversation. And is that what you call a getaway? Well, tell me what you got away with, cause you left the phrase from the ties you severed when you say best friends means friends forever. Is that what you call a getaway? Tell me what you got away with.
Not much has been really going on. Like, we've just been chilling out. The only thing that's really been going on is Garrett has just been getting completely weirder, like, as the tour goes on. Like, he used to be pretty weird, and now he's really, really weird. He's all grown his hair out, and, like, he bought this camouflage crocodile hunter hat that he wears everywhere, and he wears these heinous white leather women's shoes, and he rolls his pants up, like, mid-calf. And he's just like looking, oh my god.
Thought that might have been
you, pussy. It was close.
Met some crazy homeless guy at night with no legs. Met some crazy homeless guy with no legs named Godzilla. Oh, I gotta do it. Met some crazy homeless guy with no legs. After the show, hung out outside, met some crazy homeless guy with no legs named Godzilla. He had a 40 MGD that he was drinking all night, and I think a bottle of like peach schnapps or something. Tried to offer me a drink at least like 45 times.
No, thank you.
No. Telling crazy stories about how Jimi Hendrix died in his apartment and he's in a band called Electric God.
Your band is called Electric God, right? Hell yeah. And you were on MTV, right? What's your hat, man?
That's Electric Guy.
Oh, it says Electric Guy? Where?
Right there.
It says Calgary.
Tell me about Jimi Hendrix. What happened? Tom.
Okay. He overdosed in my room!
In your apartment, right? He died in your apartment?
In your apartment? Where were you living at the time?
Seattle.
Story checks out, man.
There it is. There you have it.
Look how drunk I'm again.
Hell yeah. And what do they call you?
Godzilla.
And what else do they call you?
American horse.
Hell
yeah. I gotta get more people to go. We're gonna have a fucking party.
A phone party.
We're gonna have a party in the foam. I wouldn't call it a foam party. I'm doing a documentary. I gotta ride my bike through the foam. How do you feel about that?
Not a problem, man.
What's up to?
We're the man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You think I can walk? I can go in with the foam? I'll pay the cover charge.
Yeah. and I'm holding my tie. Like working as a circus act, they ask me tie. She got me hype, I wanna ride it right now, yeah, yeah. Say, yeah. It's all a shell, made it money well. Those in the clothes, bring the dough.
There's a phone party right there. Yo, get your fuck out. So it's sad this doesn't suit you now. Fresh out of room, please ignore the list, but never meant to sound like this. So take me and break me, and make me strong like you. I'll be forever grateful to this and you. It's only you, beautiful, or I don't want anyone. If I can choose, it's only you. Fix me to a chain around your neck, wear me like a served in old skins, cheapens the taste. I shot the pilot, I'm begging you to fly this for me. I'm here for you to use, broken and bruised. Do you understand? It's only
paralyzed from the waist down, shot in the back by a player hater, walking through a bridge where I'm an innocent man. I'm innocent, I tell you. Y'all come see this band or whatever is going down, you know what I'm saying? I'll be there.
So that band?
Cool.
The name is Brand New.
Brand New. Go see it.
So what do you think about the band Brand New?
I hadn't heard of it. My favorite band is Brand New. My favorite band is Brand New. I love you, Brand New. Good friend.
Sorry.
Cancel out. Atención! Atención! El concierto está cancelado porque tu mama está muy feo. Gary has to go now.
What's up?
Hang up the phone.
Dick, stop.
Who is that?
What?
Fucking stop.
Who is that?
What you calling?
My sister.
Janine.
I don't know.
Janine.
Anyway.
You guys are freaking
me.
Oh my god, it was the best show I've ever been to, watching you guys.
Yeah, we paid $100 to see Brand New and gave away our vinyl, and it was all worth it.
Yeah, he gave us a free vinyl.
Man behind the scenes this tour is Indy. He's our tour manager. He lays real low. You don't see him very often, but once in a while he gets real loud. And the other day we were hanging out at Sean and Michelle's house, and he just kind of blew a gasket and started screaming at us about how we spend money.
My thing is just the money, the way you guys think is insane.
Why?
Because, no, it's seriously like,
so
no, it's not that you guys actually spend it. It's the fact that, like, it scares me when you see something you want because I'm like, fuck, they're gonna ask for money. Like, that, just because the mindset you guys have, like, you haven't done it that much. It's just like, I'm worried about that because I see you guys and you're like, your eyes light up when you see shit and you're like, yo, we should get that.
Like the fucking horns,
exactly. You guys want to start your own road rules and shit. Like, it was only 30 bucks, but it's no big deal. It's like,
but look at the horns, dude.
That's what I'm saying. It's not like
Rufio doesn't have horns. But they're jealous.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you guys aren't spending like that amount of money. It's just like, I can see you guys the rest of the tour. We'll be in fucking farm country and you'll see something and be like, yeah! You'll buy a fucking tractor or something. I know you guys. Like, it's just, you'll see something and be totally into it. And that's fine. It just worries me. Because I'm waiting for the day when you guys are like, we need a couple grand for this sick trailer that goes like 80. Like, it's just something's gonna happen. And it's not bad at all. I'm just waiting for it. Like, I can see it in all your guys' eyes. Like, when I went shopping with him at the fucking computer store, we had a computer, everything was set up. He's like, dude, I just got a loan. Like, he was ready to buy another laptop.
I was gonna buy an iBook.
Yeah, and then, like,
it lit up like blue and stuff. It was so awesome.
That, it lit up, it was blue. That's all I, that's it, dude. It lit up, it was blue. $2,000. It's blue. Oh my god. Let's go spend money.
Let's go spend money, dude.
Yeah, let's go do that. We are in Los Angeles, California, going to the Hot Topic
just
warehouse.
Want some swap meet.
Exactly.
Sitting at the railroad station, reading books about intimidation, waiting for my girl to come, and if she does, will she be dumb or really smart? Will she break my heart or wad it up and throw it in my face? I knew I'd find a nice girl someday. Find a nice girl, settle down.
What was most important to you about a live show, and what do you want people to get out of coming to see your band live? What do you want to get out of playing? What are the things that drive you in that arena?
We're more concerned with entertaining people with our music more than just like sitting there and playing our music properly.
Well, the problem is we can't play our music.
Yeah, exactly.
If we sat down on the stage in four chairs
and tried to
play the songs like it's on the record, we would fail horribly. So, you know, but at the same time, it's funny because no matter how accessible you make yourself, and you can talk to a person for an hour and just show them that you're like the most boring, you know, lame person in the world. Some people still like put you on this pedestal and they get all crazy excited about you and they, you know, they'll like touch your arm or they'll ask for an autograph and I love it. I think it's the coolest thing.
it's refreshing because I want to admit
it's every kid's dream. Yeah. It was my dream and it's happening and it's so cool. You know, so I'm never going to be like, yeah, you know, that person should ask for my autograph, or like, this, you know, this should all be happening, but when it happens, I'm definitely not the one to be like, it's just so stupid, because it's not, it's great. I mean, these kids are really excited about what's going on, and we're just going to keep giving it to them as much as we possibly can. Thanks, all.
Whatever poison's in this bottle, pulling me broken, sore and stink. But it's the genie at the bottle, who I'm sucking at. He owes me one last wish. So here's a present to let you know I still exist. I hope the next boy that you kiss has something terribly contagious on his lips. But I got a plan. I drink for 40 days and 40 nights. Every time you bend the line, you mean so much to me. Without you, tell all the English boys you meet, let the American boy back in the States. The American boy you used to date, who would do anything you say. Tell all the English boys you meet, let the American boy back in the States. The American boy you used to date, who would do anything you say. And even if her plane crashes tonight, she'll find some way to disappoint me by not burning in the wreckage or drowning at the bottom of the sea. Yes, I still taste you. Thus reserve my right to hate you. And all this empty space that you create does nothing for my flawless sense of